It is my privilege to introduce the Colfax High School student body president, Lindsay Tellman.
Interstate 80's exit 135 to Colfax. You take it every day to get to school. You might stop and get some gas, but you're probably late, so you'll say you'll get it on the way home. You stop at a few stop signs. If there's no train, you press on. But if there's a train and some traffic, you know the way around. You'll pass the shadow mural, the bear statue, the caboose, the local theater, a few homes, the baseball park, the elementary school, and finally our small school comes into sight. Yep, that's where we are, nestled in a small, tight-knit town which has a lot of history and heart. This high school isn't just in the town of Colfax, it's a part of it. Whether your parents attended Colfax or you're the first to build your connections here, this isn't just a school, it's a community. When we wear our green and white, it connects us to one another. To the Falcons that came before us and all those that will come after us. It reminds us of the relationships that we've built at pep rallies, in the nest, in the classroom, and in the workshops and on the stage. The green and white connects us to our school, the place where we share a common goal, to learn and grow as individuals. It connects us to our community, a community that includes our families and the webs of relationships that transcend our generation. Colfax High School isn't just special because it's surrounded by a loving, supportive community. Colfax is special because of the wide range of opportunities it provides for its students. Have you ever talked to a Buddhist monk? Have you ever raced piers on a giant inflatable obstacle course? Have you traveled to Oregon with a bunch of Shakespeare nerds? Won a PBL championship? Acted in front of hundreds? Created a live TV show? Sung with the choir at Disneyland? Participated in a maker fair? Traveled with your Spanish teacher to San Francisco, built a machine to race over sand, water, and land, designed a marketable product with MIT to solve fire danger in California? Colfax kids have. These 4 years have been filled with endless opportunities and experiences to learn from, all of which not only give us valuable experiences in life as young adults and forever memories, but also widen our understanding of the world. Graduating Colfax doesn't just mean that we survived high school. It means that we are entering the ever-changing world armed with tools and experiences that will help us navigate our successes, our failures, and remind us that we are resilient and we will succeed, no matter what path we choose. We have developed long-lasting relationships with our peers, staff, and community. With the support of this community, and now having completed this part of our ongoing education, we are ready to leave the nest. Trusting our instincts and connected to our community, we are taking our first steps into the adult world. Falcons, this is our time. We have gained a top-flight education and we are now faced with the question, what are we going to do with it? I feel that we have all gained a great, well-rounded education. We have deep interpersonal relationships, and with all these come responsibility to commit ourselves to something greater than our own personal pursuits. Whether it's a career, college, a branch in the military, it's our responsibility to use all that we've gained these 4 years to create a positive impact on a world that desperately needs us. We all have the knowledge, resources, and support to change our community, our state, our country, our world. As we start the next leg of our life's journey, let us remember to stay in touch, continue to build upon what we've learned, and never forget, your home is where the Falcons fly. Thank you for an amazing 4 years.
On behalf of Colfax High School, I want to welcome all the parents, extended families, and the friends of the graduates who are watching today. This has been a very challenging time for for our graduating class of 2020, our families, and our amazing staff. However, I could not be more proud of everything this class has accomplished and the relationships our staff has nurtured to support these seniors. It is said that Colfax High School is like an expensive private school because the staff is able to connect with every student to ensure their successes and make a difference in their lives. I would also like to especially thank those who have helped make this day happen. Our groundskeepers and custodial staff who take pride in making Colfax High School one of the most beautiful settings anywhere. This place is owned by our community, and our custodial and groundskeepers take care of it like it's their home. Thanks also goes out to the Colfax office staff, our counselors and teachers, whose countless hours and sleepless nights created the support a few of these seniors needed in order to graduate. Finally, I'd like to thank CTV's broadcasting teacher, Mr. Wolf, and sports anchor, Mary O'Rourke, for their countless hours of planning, film editing, and this very distinctive and outstanding virtual commencement. Not only will our seniors be graduating in this unique manner, but two very special staff members will also be graduating into retirement. Please join me in paying tribute to Colfax High School's world language teacher, curriculum specialist, and district leader, Senora Catherine Fox Anderson. Senora Fox Anderson has taught Spanish for over 30 years and has created a premier world language program with more biliteracy seals than any school in Northern California. She didn't just teach, but helped our students mature, understand the world around them, and understand themselves. Senora leaves a legacy on the hearts and minds of the past, current, and future generations of Colfax Falcons. Our second retired graduate is groundskeeper and maintenance worker, Mr. Jim Lunetta. Jim has helped create one of the most beautiful settings on any campus anywhere in the state. Our fields, our manicured garden beds, and pristine surroundings are a tribute to Jim's sincere efforts to provide the best learning environment for our students. In recognition of Jim's contributions, he was honored this year as the Placer County Classified Employee of the Year. They will be a part of the Falcon family forever and are proud graduates of the class of 2020. Several of our seniors have already been commissioned into the armed services, and we'd like to honor their sacrifices for our nation's safety and well-being. Kylie Cummings, Cameron Durr, and Benjamin Samp, United States Air Force. Jacob Brown, Blake Havens, Ethan Walker, Mauricio Wells, and Celeste Bisticelli, United States Army. Gavin Elias and Austin Mansau, United States Navy. Finally, United States Army ROTC National 3-year scholarship recipient, Travin Hyman. The class of 2020 encompasses all that is great about this generation of students who will lead our nation in the years to come. They have served our community and our greater humanity with more commitment and zeal than potentially any other class before them. As confirmation of their achievements, I'd like to list just a few of their successes. 10 valedictorians, 11 lifetime CSF recipients. CSF members are recognized for both their service to the community and scholarship, and Colfax has the most CSF lifetime members in the district. 27 biliteracy seals recognized by the gold and crimson cords for Spanish and the blue, red, and white cords for French. Again, more than any other school in the district. Recipients of just under $1 million in scholarship money. 33 PVL scholar athlete recognitions, the most of any PVL team, even though we are in a league where we are the smallest school with 4 schools that are twice our size. In athletics, this class was simply amazing even without a spring season. Colfax was able to do 5 PVL titles, 3 section titles, 7 section finalists, 3 NorCal state finalists, 3 state championships, and 9 out of the 13 athletic teams made the playoffs. The spring would have brought a 3rd straight baseball section championship, track league championship and softball league championship. Golf, swim, and tennis would have competed for league championships, and every one of these teams would have made the playoffs. This is the dominance of our special athletes and our little school. PVL Best Athletic School for winning the most league championships, twice as many as Bear River. The Colfax High School Chamber Choir would have won the national gold standard for 23 straight years, but it was canceled due to the COVID. 93% of this senior class participated in extracurricular activities, athletics, clubs, and performing arts. And just over 90% of this senior class are going off to a university, a college, or a vocational technical program. 40% going straight to a four-year college or university, and 40% will be attending a community college. Lastly, I'd like to recognize our Peregrine Honor Society, our most prestigious award, because these students contributed beyond just academics, activities, and athletics, but served their school and their community. To be a member of Peregrine, you must have a 3.75 cumulative GPA and distinguish yourself in service, support, respect, in celebration of our community and school. These select group of seniors were awarded this honor through the Faculty Council. Would the following students please be recognized? Jenna Bekus, Grace Bliss, Dylan Colon, Madeline Kramer, Travin Hyman, Panka Kernax, Mackenzie Ketwig, Alyssa Pettit, Noah Pierce, Isabella Sowie, Lindsay Tellman, and Sophia Wallach. In addition, the two following seniors embody the highest of Colfax Peregrine Honor Society and were selected as the Colfax Falcons of the Year, Alyssa Pettit and Isabella Sowie. And although we select just two who illustrate the best of what it means to be a Falcon, service, support, respect, and celebration of others, as well as resiliency and determination to learn at a very high level, every one of the students in this class have and will continue to represent those merits after they have left Colfax. So, class of 2020, as I stand here on this glorious summer morning, wearing my suit, but staring not at your wonderful families and your smiling faces, but at an empty stadium, I can't help thinking we are in unprecedented times. This has been the spring and now a summer of the most challenging circumstances for our state, our nation, and our world. There have been failed businesses, lost loved ones, empty stadiums and theme parks, socially distanced funerals, a struggling economy coupled with unmitigated public health disaster. And many of you I know have suffered through these things as well. With all that has impacted our world, it might seem frivolous to feel sad about losing your commencement ceremony, but I don't think so. A high school graduation is a big deal. It's important, and for many decades, we have celebrated in a formal way with pomp and circumstance. We want this day to be distinct, unmistakable, and linked to the countless ceremonies of the past. And no matter how many graduations I've attended, and no matter how many speeches that I prepared, when the line of graduates finally appear and begin that last long walk as high school students, I feel like I might cry, and I often do. But you are having a facsimile of that special day, a virtual commencement, that no matter how much work we put into it, it's not the same. And why can't we have this traditional ceremony? Because history found you. An event that will change the way we live was sweeping around the globe, and it found you. As your long, strange spring break started on March 13th and was extended week after week, the truth began to settle in. You were not going to have a prom, a powder puff, a senior picnic, award ceremonies, Olympic week, and finally commencement. History found you. And it also found my grandparents. On October 29th, 1929, the markets would crash and the world would begin a Great Depression that would last through World War II. They were engaged to be married, and my grandfather would lose his job on the day they eloped to the county courthouse. They thought they were finally free, free from their parents, of the town that they grew up in, and ready for a new life. But history found them. They knew that the world was rumbling all around them. But they were in a small town in Pennsylvania, and it was easy to imagine that the world was far away, that this Great Depression would not impact them, but history would find them. Soon enough, my teenage grandfather and grandmother were homeless, and they needed to go back to their parents' place. There was no honeymoon, no new dresses or suits, no new job or graduate school. But certainly, there was history day after day as they struggled to make a new life on their own. This was a long, long time ago, but eventually my grandfather, James Robinson, would become an engineer, and my grandmother, Ruth Eberhardt, a nurse. They would both contribute to the reorganization of the world's economy, and their efforts during the war would help shape a future that saw the end of global colonialism and the rise of democratic values and free market systems. We now call them the greatest generation, and they would be heralded for their sacrifices through the Great Depression and World War II. And I think about that story of my grandparents and all the young men and women who walked away from high school and toward an era that would require incredible resilience and sacrifice. And history found them, and they would remodel the world in incredibly innovative ways. And that's what you will do. So often I listen to the pundits and older generations spew insults at the youth today. Please don't heed their perspective, because every generation has participated in this ritual, and they are simply wrong. I know that you, whom we celebrate today, you won't give up. You will keep going. And we are so grateful, because we need you. We need nurses and doctors, scientists and artists, engineers, teachers, writers, and business people. Most of all, we need innovators, because now more than ever, we need people who can look at the world in a rational way and make decisions based on facts and reason and create a world that we can't even imagine yet. I wish I could give you all that you need and deserve during this graduation ceremony, but maybe you've gained something more important than a traditional commencement. Maybe, as very young people, you know something powerful, that you are being tested and you have not faltered. You will keep going. And although you're entering a very different world from the one you expected, it is a world that needs you. And nothing in life is better than being needed. I know, your parents know, your teachers know, that you are ready for what lies ahead, because you are the great class of 2020, and you will never give up. And yes, history found you on March 13th, 2020. But I know someday we'll look back as you, the class that changed history for the better, because you are the great class of 2020, and you will never give up. And yes, history found you on March 13th. But I know someday we'll look back at this class that changed history for the better, because you are the next greatest generation. You are Colfax. It is now my great honor that I introduce the valedictorians of the class of 2020. Sydney Marie Bain, Jenna Kendall Bikas, Olivia Christine De La Torre, Rose Louise Forbes, Panka Kernax, Danica Joy Macy, Alyssa Akiko Pettit, Luke David Stallions, Sophia V. Wallach, Mackenzie Diane Ketwick. Mackenzie, who received the highest GPA, a 4.46, of our distinguished valedictorian list, will now present the commencement speech for the class of 2020. Mackenzie.
Graduates, family, friends, and confused grandparents who managed to find this YouTube video, welcome to Colfax High School's first ever virtual graduation. Before watching this video, be sure to go check out our Alpha Omega Ceremony or Senior Pennant Parade for more Falcon content. And don't forget to smash those like and subscribe buttons down below. If you couldn't already tell by my cringy intro, I'm not cut out to be a vlogger at all. I'd rather see TV's best news reporter, Atania Miro, who is much more experienced speaking in front of a camera than I am, be delivering this speech. Or perhaps local TikTok stars, Jason Holm and Zach Haig, could turn us into an overnight internet sensation with their uncanny ability to generate media buzz. Class clowns Noah Pierce and Ben Samp could have you all in stitches, whereas my material isn't exactly comedy gold. Brooklyn Porter and Danielle Colburn would know exactly how to pump up a crowd as the captains of our cheerleading team. Go Falcons! Holding the honorable title of class speaker means you get to hear the perspective of the most stressed, sleep-deprived, and trusty Starbucks loyalty club member at Colfax, who just so happens to have the highest GPA. These aren't the qualities that someone needs to speak on behalf of 130 remarkably different students. I suggest looking to your own more credible role models for wisdom rather than a 17-year-old girl whose life experience could fit on a single piece of paper. If you're hoping to hear from the smartest, deepest, and most insightful kid at Colfax, then I'd recommend asking each and every graduate what they've learned during high school. After all, watching this video right now are the world's future teachers, engineers, politicians, scientists, athletes, parents, and creators. Pay attention, graduates, because now it's time for our ridiculously inadequate but nevertheless heartfelt appreciation segment. But before we can properly express our gratitude to the finest faculty, family, and friends to whom we owe our diplomas, we owe many of them an apology. First on the list is Mr. Hyde's spring term statistics class, who would like to apologize for their many, many missing assignments, Zach Starbuck. Next up is Senora Efe's Spanish 4 class, who blames their faulty alarm clocks for accidentally sleeping through many of your Google Hangouts. Mr. Devine, we promise we'll turn in our school Chromebooks as soon as we find the chargers that go with them. They haven't had power since the beginning of quarantine, or more likely, since the beginning of senior year. Robbo, Schofer, Bratton, Hammer, and any other teacher who's had the misfortune of deciphering Ben Cross's handwriting, he's especially sorry. But I think we can all agree his brilliant essays make up for their lack of clarity. Lastly, to every teacher at Colfax who tried to virtually connect with us during quarantine, we're sorry for not being the most attentive students, even when you were the hardest working instructors. Thank you for quickly adapting to an entirely virtual form of education so that we could all meet the graduation requirements and be here today. We will miss Mr. Stauer's action-packed lectures and total domination of the stock market game. Ms. Schofer, no one will ever have as strong a connection to your feet as Wyatt Paul, or learn so much in your classes as our grade's rowdiest boys. As one of the students that lived in Mr. Hyde's back room and witnessed golf tournaments, ukulele concerts, and many calculus parties, I can tell you that there will never be a place quite like it anywhere else. I'm still not sure how John Lewis, Cameron Durr, or Luke Stallions got the idea to set up a makeshift golf course in there, but Golfland's Fun Splash has got nothing on our back hallway. To the wonderful staff in the office, I can't imagine we were easy to schedule, but you were extremely helpful in reminding us of our responsibilities as students and providing new job and scholarship opportunities as well. One of the most memorable and essential parts of high school is the food, and the ladies in the cafeteria worked hard to feed us all. Preston Sladek gives you all 5 stars for his salad bar experiences. Honestly though, one of the groups on campus we owe our biggest apologies and thanks to is our custodial staff. Jody, I can't believe some of the stories that you've told me involving chocolate milk messes and vandalism problems, but we are beyond grateful for our clean campus that you and other dedicated custodial staff have provided us with. Thank you all for the special memories you've given us. I can't think of anywhere else we would have received this much attention and encouragement. Don't worry, parents, I haven't forgotten about you. How could I when you've brought us to school at 6 a.m. for choir rehearsals or stayed late until 11 to get us from football games? You are by far our most steadfast supporters. You've laughed with us, cheered for us, and believed in us as we've taken our next steps towards becoming adults. Whether you drove us hundreds of miles for sports tournaments, flew across the country to watch us sing at Carnegie Hall, showed up for our SoundTube convention freshman year, or even just made us lunch, you've done so much for us. Seriously, Jenna Bikas and her mom are master chefs in the kitchen. Their meals could be featured in magazines. But perhaps your hardest job of all has been motivating us during these past few months. Successfully dragging miserable teenagers out of their pitch black bedrooms and into the light is terrifying for many, but you did it. You went the extra mile and helped us establish routines that kept us safe and focused on making it through the school year.
We know it wasn't the best time to be around us, a bunch of depressed seniors who just wanted their sports seasons and fun field trips. But you've been patient while we've adjusted to our new circumstances and extra appreciative of our accomplishments. Thank you for never once giving up on us. Lastly, I'd like to thank my friends, my fellow graduates from the class of 2020. I know it's more than a little cheesy to say this out loud, but we actually are the leaders of tomorrow. I probably just broke the number one rule of what not to say in a valedictorian speech, but it's still true. None of us could have done this without our incredible friends and classmates, who've had our backs during every sports game, Maker's Fair, theater performance, and embarrassing moment. I can truthfully say that I've learned more from all of you than from anyone else. In my time at Colfax, I've both collaborated with and experienced the amazing influence that these students have had on their fellow classmates and our community. Madeline Kramer has been advocating for our planet's protection from climate change through founding Colfax High School's very own environmental club and helping organize an event dedicated to better educating our local community. I couldn't have been more excited to work alongside her, and we all know her biggest achievements are yet to come. This class has many standout students who know that the key to being a great leader is to lead by example. Alyssa Pettit is someone who embodies this through her compassion to help everyone and to ensure that Colfax is a safe and inclusive place for every student. Her work with the LGBTQ+ club on campus has helped many students to find their voices. Isabella Sawi is probably the kindest leader I've ever met, someone that everyone wants to be friends with because she's genuinely a good person and wants happiness above all else for her friends. Those times we studied together at Starbucks before school were the only times I've ever smiled at 5 a.m. One of the most inspirational things about this class is that we know no bounds. We never intended to plan the fastest routes through grocery stores instead of winning strategies for Olympic week, but that's exactly what we did. We'd hoped of playing for championship titles with our teammates one last time, rather than practicing alone in our backyards. Instead of smiling for prom pictures and dancing with our friends, we masked our faces to protect the people we love from illness. This year has asked much more of us than we ever anticipated. The goals written during our senior sunrise now seem like mocking taunts from our past oblivious selves. We'd planned to leave our legacies behind as the class who had set higher expectations for future Falcons in spirit, determination, and unity. I'd planned to talk about our collective growth as a class, comparing our freshman failures to our senior successes. The history we thought we'd leave behind has disappeared. The achievements we've accomplished have faded, and the stories I've been waiting to tell since ninth grade just don't exist. We lost our athletic seasons, our award ceremonies, and the fulfillment that comes with a traditional happy ending. The pandemic has cost us arguably the best part of high school, but we refuse to be remembered in history as the class who never walked. Out of all of the words in Webster's dictionary that have been used in valedictorian speeches, pity and loss will not be the ones that define us. We're rewriting history with better and more accurate versions. We're learning to advocate for our beliefs and change what the world defines as a successful high school graduate. Our generation's technological capability and unshakable belief in the American values of liberty and justice for all have rejuvenated the social and environmental activism movement in a way not seen since Rabo and Stower's beloved 60s. I hope they're glowing with pride, not only at our sincere commitment to creating a more just society, but also because I actually remember something they taught us. Ultimately, we've gained a stronger sense of our school, our community, and ourselves. It doesn't make up for the months of devastation or outrage you might have felt because of what you lost, but it has shown us the reality high school has been trying to prepare us for all along, that life isn't fair, but it still goes on. No matter how hard life becomes, it will never relieve us of our responsibility as human beings to make it the best we possibly can. Before I do my outro and let you get back to the regularly scheduled program, there are a few people I'd like to thank for helping my dreams come true these past 4 years. To my mom and to my sister Megan, thank you for listening to this speech hundreds of times. Without you, it would not have been possible. You've both been my toughest and proudest supporters. To Mr. Hild, who has helped me tirelessly these past 4 years in all of my endeavors. Words cannot describe how you've impacted my life. To Potato Farm, aka the girls from the class of 2019, thank you for accepting a know-it-all sophomore into your group and showing me the ropes of high school. To the Pierce family, with whom I've enjoyed our Marvel marathons and many meals. Good luck to you, Maya, and all of the incoming freshmen. This year is one for the history books. Lastly, to my dad, whose work ethic and integrity lives on in me and to whom this speech is dedicated. Thank you, Colfax High School, for helping me become the person I am today. Well, everyone, I've got to say that you've been a great audience. Make sure to comment down below if you actually laughed at my jokes or not, since I can't tell. Also, don't hesitate to visit Colfax's other YouTube channel, Colfax Math by Mr. Schwartz, to brush up before summer comes to an end. My only piece of advice in this speech will be to the rest of the classes. Appreciate every day of high school because you never know which one will be your last. You are Colfax, and we, the class of 2020, is out.
I would now like to present to you Mrs. Lynn McDonald, Placer Union High School District Trustee, the Colfax High School Class of 2020.
As a Placer Union High School District Board Trustee, I certify to you and accept from you that members of this class have met the graduation requirements of the Placer Union High School District and the state of California.
Kenneth James Anderson thought high school was outstanding. He will miss the fun people and the awesome memories. Kenneth will be attending Sierra College in the fall.
Sydney Marie Bain will be studying criminal justice at Sacramento State University, as well as participating on their women's rowing team. She would like to thank her friends and family for their continued support.
Nellie Rose Balk would like to thank her family for pushing her to do her best throughout high school and her teachers for making her experience incredible. Nellie plans on attending the phlebotomy program at Sierra College.
Alec James Beal will attend Yuba Community College and play baseball while studying fire science. After 2 years, he will attend the Fire Academy to pursue a career as a firefighter. Alec would like to thank his parents, family, friends, teachers, and coaches.
John Joseph Beckman would like to thank his family, coaches, teachers, and friends for pushing him to meet his potential and for their guidance throughout the last 4 years. John will be attending Sierra College.
Jenna Kendall Beekus plans to study photography at Cal Baptist University. Her fondest memories of high school include the chamber choir tours, the endless ceramics projects, using makeshift dark rooms in photography, and being involved in way too many clubs.
Daniel Robert Bliss would like to thank his parents and sister for their unconditional support. Daniel plans to attend Sierra College and later transfer to a four-year university to pursue forensic science.
Grace Ann Bliss will be attending Cal Poly San Luis Obispo to study biology and pursue her basketball career on a full-ride scholarship. She would like to thank her family, friends, teammates, and coaches for shaping her into the best version of herself. She loves you all and will miss Colfax dearly.
Zachary John Bliss would like to thank Mrs. Hammond, Coach Stowers, Miss Moneypenny, Miss Udall, and his girlfriend for helping him push through his senior year. He will study at Sierra College.
Alexis Marie Bakke would like to take this time to appreciate her teachers and all of the Colfax High School staff for their undying love and assistance. Their compassion showed Lexi what it truly meant to be a Falcon. Thank you, Colfax.
Jaden Schuyler Briggs plans to intern next year as a videographer and will pursue a career as an automotive journalist. A big thank you to his parents. Jaden would not be here today if not for their encouragement to complete school.
Carrie Letha Brown plans to attend Sierra College majoring in business. She would like to thank her teachers for helping her through high school and her family for being supportive.
Jacob Darrell Brown. Jacob made and achieved his goal of graduating early. Following a long line of family military members, he leaves for Army Basic Training in June. His MOS is 15U, Chinook Helicopter Mechanic. He's grateful for the support of his family and friends.
Caitlin Elizabeth Brown graduated early and has been studying elementary education at Sierra College. She would like to thank her family and friends, most importantly her father and Mrs. Schofer, for never letting her settle.
Samuel David Brown will be attending the University of Montana Western in Dillon. He will study business and earn a guide license. He plans to work as a hunting and fly fishing guide in Montana.
Matthew Joseph Buettner plans on attending Sierra College to study information technology. Matthew would like to thank all the staff, teachers, and his friends. He would also like to thank Mr. Marson for being a great mentor.
Dakota Zen Campos, would like to thank his mom, stepdad, and siblings for their constant love and encouragement. Dakota will major in industrial design at Western Washington University. He wants to pursue a career in design for an athletic brand.
Elizabeth Marie Cerna will be attending Sierra College to pursue a career in technical theater. She would like to thank all of her teachers, especially Mr. Reed, Senora Jaquez, Mrs. Schofer, and Mrs. Ortega for their endless amounts of guidance.
Daniel Alicia Colburn would like to thank her family and the amazing staff at Colfax for supporting her through these last 4 years. Danielle will pursue her dream of becoming a kindergarten teacher, studying early childhood studies at CSU Channel Islands.
Dylan Henry Cologne plans to attend Sierra College and would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers, as well as those that have encouraged him. Dylan plans to earn an economics degree.
Gavin Conley.
Madeline May Kramer will be attending UC Santa Barbara to study biology and eventually become a physician assistant. She is grateful for the incredible 4 years at CHS and would like to thank her family, friends, teachers, and coaches for their endless support.
Benjamin James Cross is incredibly thankful for the wonderful teachers that made his education at Colfax possible. He hopes to attend Humboldt University to earn his BA in political science. Following that, he hopes to attend law school.
Kylie Kennedy Cummins will be enlisting in the United States Air Force working in military intelligence. She would like to thank her friends, family, and especially her teachers for their continuous guidance.
May Virginia Daly plans to attend Chico State University to study biochemistry. She would like to say a huge thank you to her family and friends for supporting her throughout these 4 years.
Olivia Kristen De La Torre will be attending Cal Poly San Luis Obispo studying biochemistry. She would like to thank her parents for their love, her little brother for sitting through her dance performances, and her best friend for being her partner in math.
Cameron Mitchell Durr has enlisted in the United States Air Force and will attend basic training this summer. He has passed the test for cybersecurity and is awaiting an opening in that field. Go Falcons!
Callie Ray Dilly plans to join the Navy with the aspiration to become a part of law enforcement. She'd like to thank her mom and the Martinez family for always being supportive and genuinely kind people. She's beyond lucky to have them in her life.
Kiana Joy Donaldson wants to continue her education and career in nursing. She'd like to thank her friends and teachers for making high school a great and pleasant memory.
Ryan Stewart Donovan plans to attend Denver University to study business. He would like to thank his parents and friends for helping him along the way. Ryan will never forget the memories he made during high school, especially while on the snowboard team.
Wiley Stewart Drummond. His greatest accomplishment in high school was winning the section championship over Bear River. He'd like to thank his coaches, family, and friends for making him who he is today.
Gavin Siller Elias. Gavin is very excited for his future in the Navy. His fondest memories are with his friends and swimming. Gavin wants to thank his family for helping him and motivating him through the last 3 years.
Joshua Jeffrey Erickson plans to continue his education and become certified in auto body repair and paint at American River College. He'd like to thank his parents for fostering his passion for automobiles and the teachers and staff at Colfax High.
Robert Townsend Everhart II.
Rose Lewis Forbes will be attending Northern Arizona University studying criminal justice and political science. She'd like to thank her parents and teachers for always supporting and believing in her and for pushing her to follow her dreams.
Caleb Andrew Forseth is planning on attending Sierra College to study theatrical arts. After that, it's all a mystery.
Andre Cameron Furlano would like to thank his family for helping him turn around his academic career, ensuring that he would graduate.
Tyler Andrew Gansberg Tyler will be leaving for the United States Marine Corps at the end of July with aspirations to have a future in air traffic control.
Dylan Hunter Garcia will be attending Sierra College to keep pursuing his football career and will study fire science. Dylan's favorite memory was when he broke the longest field goal record. He would like to thank his family for supporting him.
Rachel Elizabeth Garcia plans on continuing her education. Without her family, her friends, staff, and her teachers, she wouldn't have made it through. Thank you for not giving up on her.
Jennifer Lee Garten has enjoyed Colfax and will continue her education at Sierra College. Her favorite memory was the softball playoffs. She would like to thank her friends and parents for supporting her, and Mr. Lumberg for always making an effort to say hi.
Wyatt Earl Gibson plans to attend Sierra College to earn an associate's degree in applied arts and design and transfer to Woodbury College to earn a bachelor degree in computer animation. Wyatt would like to thank his mom, dad, and sister for their support.
Mitchell Robert Gilstrap wants to thank his wonderful teachers for their effort and guidance and his parents for their unconditional love and support. Mitchell would like to wish his classmates healthy and prosperous futures.
Seth Glassick wants to thank his friends and family. He enjoyed his years here at CHS, especially being a TA in the office, assisting the staff each day. Seth encourages the students of Colfax to have a nice time while they are here.
Marina Lee Gravala will be attending Pepperdine University in Malibu, majoring in biology. She would like to thank Colfax High for cultivating such an amazing community and for supporting her academic growth.
Logan Forrest Grimes plans to attend Sierra College to become an RN. He would like to thank his mom, stepdad, brother, grandma, and friends for all of their love and support. Hugs and kisses.
William James Groth will run cross country at American River College. He'd like to thank his friends, family, and coaches for always supporting him.
Zacharias Chad Haig. After high school, Zach plans on going to lineman school to work for PG&E. Zach would like to thank the CHS staff, family, and friends for helping him. There's no way he could have done it without you all.
Abigail Grace Hanaway graduated early and has been attending Sierra College. She'd like to thank her family for their constant love and support and her friends for the great memories.
Jason Bennett Harris will be playing baseball at Sierra College and studying computer science. He would like to thank his family, friends, and coaches for their support.
Logan Wayne Harris plans to work for PG&E. He'd like to thank his parents, family, friends, and football coaches for their endless support throughout high school.
Blake Lee Havens is joining the Army for 3 years and then plans to study criminal justice. He would like to thank his family and friends for their love and support.
Harley Ann Hawk is thankful for her time at Colfax because of the friends, memories, and experiences that it provided. She has come across many influential people here who have changed her life, and they will always have a special place in her heart.
Travin Mark Hyman will attend the University of Oregon and take part in the Army ROTC program. He would like to thank his family for being great role models and his teachers and coaches for helping him shape him into the person he is today. We are Colfax, and go Ducks!
Zachary Chad Hillier plans to attend Sierra Community College and study to become an IT technician. Zach would like to thank his dad, mom, stepmom, aunt, and uncle for supporting him, guiding him through school, and encouraging him to strive for a better future.
Jason Zachary Holm will be playing baseball and studying at Yuba College with plans to transfer to a four-year school. Friday Night Lights, girls' basketball games, winning section championships, and the friends he made are his fondest CHS memories.
Cody Nicholas Holthy would like to thank his grandma, mom, dad, and aunt for attending so many of his games and supporting him through school and soccer. Cody would also like to thank Ms. Schofer, Mr. Stowers, Ms. Isham for showing him what it means to be a Falcon.
Rebecca Grace J. Rebecca's story is the same as everyone else's. She showed up her freshman year nervous, made some friends, and gained confidence. Now that her senior year is over, she's going into college being nervous again, knowing that everyone will have her back.
Panka Kernax plans to attend Sierra College and transfer to UC Berkeley, where she will study environmental science and/or natural sciences. She'd like to thank her mom, dad, little brother, and grandparents for making her the person she is today.
Glenda Jacqueline Kiesner will study nursing at Sacramento State with aspirations to become a pediatric nurse. She would like to thank her family and friends for their love and support.
Mackenzie Diane Ketwig is off to Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. While at CHS, she advised the U.S. Surgeon General, was elected Girls State Secretary of State, president of the PCYC, and was on the PUHSD school board. Mostly, she will remember the community, the joyous, loving, and helping people of Colfax.
Christian Paul Kimbrell.
Damian George Kish will begin his adventure at Sierra College, then go on to Sacramento State studying anthropology and archaeology. He'd like to thank his mom, dad, and his grandma. He hopes to inspire future generations just like he was inspired by Josh Gates, a producer archaeologist on television.
Maximus Sierra Koenig will attend a junior college after high school and then go on to a four-year to study sports therapy. He would like to thank his mom, dad, and brother for their help along the way.
Destiny Marie Lang would like to thank Mrs. Hammond and Mrs. Kima for helping her with her high school career.
Michael John Lavinier plans to attend Linfield College to play baseball and study sports management with a dream to play professional baseball. He would like to thank his entire family, friends, and coaches for always believing and supporting him.
Sophia Catherine Lewis wants to thank her parents and Trish for helping her get into her perfect school. Sophia will be attending Pacific University, where she'll study creative writing.
Sophia Lynn Lizarde will be attending Sierra College this upcoming year. She plans to become a high school English teacher, taking after her role models here at Colfax, Ms. Schofer and Mrs. Jenkins.
Danica Joy Macy plans on attending the University of Montana Western in hopes of becoming a Montana State Game Warden. She wants to thank her teachers for pushing her to be her best and her parents for teaching her to always make time for fun.
Isaac Maldonado will spend the next 2 years at Sierra College and then transfer to Chico State in order to earn his business degree. Isaac hopes that someday he will own a business in clothing.
Austin William Mansu has enlisted in the U.S. Navy and will be stationed in Great Lakes, Chicago. He would like to thank his mom and Dennis for guiding him in the right direction.
Karina Erica Martel will be attending Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, majoring in biomedical engineering. Her best memory at Colfax was winning the state ski title as a freshman. She would like to thank Miss Bratton for being her role model and her family for the constant guidance.
Samantha Annalise Mayer plans to pursue a career in nursing with hopes of becoming a neonatal nurse. She'd like to thank her mom, dad, grandma, and everyone else who have guided her throughout high school.
Robert Michael McCann would like to thank his brothers, parents, and his friends for a great time at CHS. Robert plans to attend Sierra College with intent on transferring to SDSU later on.
Alina Grace Mejia is a devoted actor, spending most of her time in the theater. She plans to take the memories, skills, and experiences she has learned and created with her into the real world.
Atania Rose Merrow-Schmidt is planning on attending Sierra College studying criminology. She would like to thank Mr. Wolf and the CTV program for helping her pursue her passions and grow as a person.
Caitlin Michael Malloy would like to thank her parents and sister for their love and encouragement, and Mrs. Hitchcock for always being available to chat. She couldn't have done it without you guys.
Cole James Moore. He would like to thank everyone involved in the Colfax community. He would like to especially thank his friends and family for all the love and support. Next year, Cole will attend San Jose State University.
Kylie Ann Morgan. Kylie plans on going to school to be a veterinary technician. Her biggest accomplishment in high school would be training her Mustang Cowboy. She would like to thank her parents and friends for supporting her through these last 4 years.
Taylor Sue Morgan became a certified medical assistant as a senior. She would like to thank her parents for helping her through her senior year and her girlfriend for being her biggest supporter.
Haley Elizabeth Mulick plans on attending Sierra College. She is looking forward to playing volleyball there while pursuing career opportunities. She'd like to thank her family and friends for making Colfax High School an experience she will never forget.
Brittany Anna Louise Neely.
Walker Monroe Nelson will study at Sierra College, transfer to a four-year, then work on his post-undergraduate education. He'd like to thank his favorite teachers, his friends, and family for believing in him.
Chance William Nedemeyer would like to thank his friends and family, but most importantly, a special thanks to his parents, Amy and Joe.
Kaylee Joy Elizabeth Nozel. After furthering her education at Sierra College, Kaylee plans on studying cosmetology. She'd like to thank her friends, family, and the community for being the best support system out there, and especially her mom for being her rock.
Elijah David Newtonboom. During his time at Colfax, Eli was the vice president of the EA Club and founder and president of the CAI Club. He plans to join the Army and become a 91 Bravo, then continue his education in engineering.
Peter David Hunter O'Brien will be attending Sierra College. He'd like to thank his mom, dad, coaches, teachers, and friends for all the time and energy spent in making his high school experience something that he will cherish forever.
Miranda Paige Odgers plans to attend NDSCS in North Dakota this fall. She would like to thank her aunts, her uncles, mother, and her grandmother for all their efforts and endless encouragement to get her here today.
Johnny Lewis Pantlick will attend Yuba College to further his baseball career while studying business and then transfer to a four-year. He'd like to thank his friends, family, coaches, teachers, and his favorite person, Sydney Marie. He is excited for the future.
Wyatt Lane Paul plans to study biology at Sierra College to pursue his career as a wildlife biologist. His favorite memories include Mrs. Schofer's class and his baseball team. He thanks his family and baseball coaches.
Kaylee Ray Petrilla would like to thank her friends and family for all their guidance and love. Kaylee will be attending Sierra College with hopes to become an EMT.
Alyssa Akiko Pettit will be attending Cogswell Polytechnical College of Art and Design in Silicon Valley, pursuing her degree in animation and game art design, and hopes to be part of a big project someday.
Noah Isaac Pierce would like to thank Ramos, Wallace, and Preston for being the most supportive friends he could have ever asked for, as well as his family and his girlfriend for being there for him. Noah will be attending San Diego State University for media production.
Gabriel Andrew Piet will attend Sierra College in the fall to pursue his career in video production and editing. His ultimate goal is to work in Hollywood as a cameraman or cinematographer.
Celeste Marie Pisticelli. Celeste plans to join the U.S. Army, hoping to eventually pilot helicopters. She also hopes to travel to as many places as she can. She'd like to thank everyone who put up with her and that pushed her to do her very best, like her friends and family.
Leonardo Isaac Cuevas Pernebo had a great time creating grand experience with his friends and exploring the many facets of high school, such as math, art, and sports. He will use all of this knowledge as he pursues a career in computer science.
Brooklyn Chelsea Porter plans to attend Brigham Young University in Idaho. Her favorite memory from high school is the time spent with her friends. She'd like to thank her parents and her sisters for teaching her what is most important in life.
Jessica Noel Pratt will attend Sierra College and then transfer to the University of Washington to study psychology in hopes of becoming a psychologist. She would like to thank her friends and family for supporting her throughout the years.
Cassidy Lee Redfern.
Maylene Janelle Reyes plans to go to our local community college to major in art and minor in cosmetology. She would like to thank her beautiful mother for always pushing her to succeed and her wonderful friends for being there through the thick and thin.
Justin James Richardson will be attending Sierra College, then transferring to Yuba College to become a radiology technician. Justin's greatest accomplishment was making All-League for varsity golf. Justin enjoyed making lots of lasting friendships.
Ethan Kevin Rogers would like to thank his parents because they told him to be sure to include them. So thanks, Mom and Dad. He plans on attending Sierra College before transferring to UC Davis to study medicine.
Benjamin Isaac Samp has a passion for aviation and hopes to become a pilot in the Air National Guard. He will never forget the memories he has made with his friends, the newest interests he has found, and the skills he has learned over these last 4 years.
Emma Louise Sanders will be running cross-country and track at Sierra College with the intent to transfer to a 4-year and become a teacher. Emma would like to thank her friends, family, and the teachers that have helped her along the way.
Luke Shane William Sarnecki.
Joshua Neil Saunders.
Isabella Jade Claire Sowie plans to attend Cabrillo College to study marine biology. She thanks her parents, brother, and extended family for always supporting her and her friends for making high school that much better.
Adele Sill transferred to Colfax her sophomore year. It was the best decision she made. She now plans on earning her nursing degree. She would like to thank her dad, brother, and sister for giving her their courage and drive to do what's best for her.
Samuel William Siner.
Preston Scott Sladek will attend Long Beach State's engineering program and take his pole vaulting to the collegiate level. Preston would like to thank his mom, dad, and sister for all of their love and guidance.
Jenna Kathleen Smith plans to attend Oregon State University in the fall, majoring in psychology. She would like to thank her whole family for always being with her no matter what.
Krista Lillian Snyder plans to attend Mary Baldwin University to earn a nursing degree with aspirations to become a trauma nurse. She would like to thank all of her friends, her parents, her brother, and sister for all that they have done.
Danica Marie Spain would like to thank her family and friends for all the love, and a special thanks to Mrs. Jenkins, Miss Ortega, Mr. Stowers, and Mr. Siebels for pushing her to be her best self. Danica plans to attend SNHU to study business management with aspirations to run her own company.
Luke David Stallions plans to attend Yuba College to continue his baseball career. He will study either data analytics or sports journalism. Luke would like to thank his family, friends, teachers, and coaches who have made his journey at Colfax incredible.
Zachary Ray Starbuck would like to thank his parents for the love, encouragement, and determination that has helped him keep on the right path. He will continue his education at Sierra College. He would also like to thank his brother Noah for inspiring him with his drive and self-discipline.
Hudson Garrett Stroop graduated early and has spent the last few months traveling. He plans to help our varsity football team next year and hopes to play football while in college. Hudson would like to thank his family, friends, girlfriend, and coaches.
Cruz Eugene Suarez would like to thank his friends and family, his teachers, for making graduation possible, Wendy for making him coffee even when he was late to class, and his big bro, Mr. Lumberg.
Jordan Rose Tavares plans to attend Sierra College, then transfer to UC Davis to pursue a nursing degree. She would like to thank her mom, dad, and friends for pushing her to be there. Special shout out to the seniors for allowing her to be class president.
Lindsay Ellen Tellman will attend UC San Diego, majoring in political science. She hopes to attend law school in order to become a prosecutor for Placer County. Lindsay would like to thank her parents, sisters, teachers, dogs, and boyfriend for supporting her.
Alex Ryan Thomason plans to go to a junior college for 2 years, then transfer to a university. His fondest memory was hanging out with his friends after prom. Alex would like to thank his parents for being there when things were hard.
James Timothy Thompson.
Kyra Mia Katrina Thompson recalls walking onto campus and thinking, wow, this is going to be awful. School has never been her forte. It was a dreaded wait. Here's what she didn't know. She didn't know about the new family she'd find.
William Andrew Torres plans to attend Sierra College to study IT with aspirations to join the field of technology. He would like to thank his friends and family for all their love and support.
Cassidy Ann Tracy would like to thank her family and best friends for always making her smile, and each of her coaches for making such an impact in her life. Cassidy aspires to become a nurse anesthetist and follow in the steps of her mother.
Crystal Nicole Trulin came to California this year and was a part of the Engineering Arts Club as well as the Falcon Drumline. Her biggest accomplishment was choreographing the Drumline Winter Show. She plans on attending Sacramento State this fall.
Sarah Ann Vogel. Her greatest accomplishment was taking AP art classes. She will never forget the friendships and memories made around the ceramics table. Sarah would like to thank all of her teachers, family, and friends for always being there for her. Sarah will continue her education at Sierra College.
Mariah Ann Vasugi will study phlebotomy at Sierra College. She'd like to thank her family for supporting and pushing her to do better and their unconditional love. Mariah would like to thank Colfax for all the memories.
Ethan James Walker.
Sophia Vay Wallach plans to attend Point Loma University to study applied health and science. Some of Sophia's best memories include the last soccer game against Center and spending time with her friends. She'd like to thank her family for always being supportive.
Mauricio Nathaniel Wells has enlisted in the U.S. Army. He would like to thank his family and friends for their encouragement.
Trace Stephen Williams is passionate about cars. He will attend Wyotech in Wyoming and study to become an auto technician. He has had a great time and has made great friends at CHS. He especially loved being on the snowboard team.
Molly Elizabeth Wilson will be attending University of Nevada, Reno, majoring in environmental engineering. She would like to thank her family, especially her mom and dad, for all of the endless love and support. It wouldn't have been possible without you guys.
Molly Elizabeth Wines wholeheartedly thanks her friends and family for their support and encouragement. Molly will be attending the University of Nevada, Reno in the fall with plans on becoming a nurse.
Thea Rochelle Workman plans to attend Sierra College for her first 2 years, then transfer to a California State University to study psychology. She would like to thank her mom, dad, and sisters for always guiding and encouraging her.
And now let's look back and enjoy our fight song one last time.
West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place. Moonshine, teardrop in my eye, country road.